1 John 5:14 at the bottom says, we can be confident that he will listen to us whenever we ask him for anything in line with his will. That's important. We can be confident that he will do what? That he'll listen. He hears us. You've got to know that anything you come bring before the Lord, if it's his word, he hears and he's listening. And if he's listening, what is he going to do? Amen. He's going to answer it.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
Amen. Somebody, the Lord is good.
The Lord is good.
And he's worthy to be praised.
He's worthy to be praised.
Tell a couple of people around you that.
The Lord is good.
Oh, yes,
he's
good. I know he is good.
How are you doing? How are you?
Mighty. Good and mighty.
There is none like him.
None. Praise him.
How many of you have lived long enough to find out that you can search throughout all eternity?
Oh, hallelujah!
And find
none. Glory, glory!
Hallelujah!
Like him.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
There's none like him. None like him. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Woo, none like him.
So I put demands on my soul.
Yes.
To praise him. And to bless his name.
Oh Lord.
Come on. Tell somebody, demand.
Demand.
Your soul.
Your soul.
That's who you are. That's your intellect, your will, your emotions, everything that makes you you is found in the soul realm.
Hallelujah.
And you have to tell it what to do.
That's right.
Wow.
He's still
or it will run amok.
Wow.
How many of you know that that's so?
Yes.
If you don't command your soul, your mind, what to think.
Jesus, have mercy.
Well,
many of us, in fact, all of us are creative because God made us that way.
That's right.
Some have different degrees of creativity.
That's right. Like Frankenstein.
But it only takes a second for you to think the wrong thing. How many of you have active imaginations?
Yeah.
Come on, I mean, and you know, if left to your own, and you're not controlled, your word, your mind is not controlled by the word.
Have mercy.
My Lord.
Have mercy.
Willfully. Volitionally.
Yes.
Controlled by the word. How many of you know your mind will run amok? Thank God that there are things that we cannot do that our minds may have suggested. Or things that we have not done that our minds have suggested. Amen. There is something to be said about waking up in your right mind. There are those who will castigate and talk about those folks who have been serial killers and what have you. Saints, there go we. Save the grace of God. How many of you would tell the truth? You've had death wishes for some. not just one, for some. And I know it's more than three. So, what I know is that our God is a mighty God. He's an awesome God. Amen. Had we followed through with some of the things our minds conceived in the big house or under the ground, because some of us would be strategic enough to set up strategies that would help in our minds us evade capture. Yeah, I know some of y'all. Come on. There's some people who are meditative and they are strategic. They don't just do things haphazardly.
That's right. Intentional.
Calculated.
Oh, Lord.
We know about it.
Mighty.
God is the preserver. Of our hearts and our minds. It's not so much that he saved you from the enemy, except that enemy be yourself, your mind and your thoughts. Can you just salute and praise the Lord for keeping your mind? That you're here, and so it is a good indication that he has kept your mind.
Yes.
Because the enemy's plan is not that you would survive, or that you would flourish, or that you would prosper. Rather, his mind and his plan is that you could be seduced. By your own flesh. The Bible says that we are enticed and we're drawn away by our own lust, our own passions, our own selves, if you will. Our own idolatry. Tell somebody idolatry,
idolatry
is the issue. I have taught for many years that pride is idolatry, and that it is that pride that often rules most decisions we make and keeps us hemmed up and bound. Beginning Tuesday, we're going to be studying God's at War, the pile item. One of the things he says is that idolatry is the issue. It is not an issue. It is the issue. That while pride is idolatrous, it is not the strong man. Idolatry is the strong man. So on Tuesday night, we're going to start our six-week session again. We'll be dealing with this God's at War. And I will tell you, it's not for the faint of heart. But if you can, and you will, and you want to grow, we invite and encourage you to come from 6 to 7, just an hour, to Bible study. Six sessions on, as you know, this will be our last six sessions for the year. Then we'll start again in January. God's at war, and those of you who can't make it to Bible study will be available starting next Sunday, and so you can gather your minutes. It will cost you $15.
Yep.
So, plug for Randall. Give this to Lamette, please. Thank you. All right. How many of you know what your idols are? All right, some of them are. So, most of us know we have at least one. I'll venture to tell you that you have probably at least two. At least. Yourself being the first one. Well, see, what we read is God will have no other gods beside him. And we take that word in our Western culture, beside, to be a hierarchy. But we need to look at the Hebraic essence of it, and it does not have to do with hierarchical concerns. It doesn't mean above him or necessarily in place of him, because sometimes we have anesthetized ourselves by saying, well, you know, I trust God, I believe God, I love the Lord, I worship the Lord. Not above, not in place of, but in addition to. Can you say that?
Idolatry
involves anything,
anything
that we have, in worship, or obedient surrender to, in addition to God. So if we look at the in addition to, then it our paradigm shifts from thinking above or in place of. I don't have anything above God or in place of God, all right? But do you have anything and God? I would venture to tell you that, yes, we do. Because how many of us consult ourselves? With various decisions and choices we make. And like to boast in the fact that we are grown. We are adults. God made me with good sense. Have you ever placed your good sense next to the Word? Has it ever replaced what the Word has said? In your thinking, in your decision, hallelujah. Has your good sense ever instructed you as to how to deal with situations and circumstances and people. Oh, yeah. Come on. It's the truth. Coupled with our good sense is often the suggestions that we make while we say we don't live by the zodiac. It does not mean that we don't identify with any of it and observe and pronounce many of its characteristics or attributes. Fact, if we're not careful, we'll find that we will identify ourselves and people according to zodiac signs. Tongue talking, fire baptized.
Wow.
Jesus on your mind.
Oh yeah.
Zodiac
as
an item.
That's right.
Not double-minded, he's just a Gemini. He's not rebellious, he's just a Taurus.
Oh, oh, now.
That's all it
is.
How many times have we substituted what God has said and made it, in a way, something less than what he said, although you can't change what God has said. We do the same thing, yes, with temperaments. They just choleric. Well, I wouldn't say they're stubborn and rebellious. They just phlegmatic or melancholy or choleric. They're not just busy in other men's matters. It's just their temperament. Saints, let me tell you. Rose by any other name.
Wow.
Still rose. Sin by any other name.
Wow.
Still sin. So you can try to clean it up, fix it up, make it smell good. Any of that, understand a frog is a frog, and if it's alive and well, it's gonna hop.
Yes. All right.
So when it starts hopping,
don't be too bad.
No need of calling on God. You knew it was a frog. So when it starts acting like one, don't get it twisted. God didn't do anything to you. Well, why didn't it stop? Because he gave you free will and told you what to do with your will and with your mind. And if you don't do it, he's also told us the antithesis of that. Well, bless the name of the Lord. I will keep him in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on me. It doesn't make you a zombie. It doesn't make you inactive. It doesn't make you dull and ignorant. But I will keep him.
I did.
In my peace, I will keep him free from anxiety as he keeps his mind, his focus, his attention on me.
Lord.
Doesn't get it twisted. thinking that he can do something about his situation. Doesn't misunderstand that he can fix anybody, even himself. The only thing we can do is surrender our will, and even at that, we need his help. Come on, tell somebody I need the help of the Lord. And yet God has given us some options. And he's told us some choices to make. And he's told us the consequences of making those choices. Yet how much time have we spent praying for people who volitionally choose not to surrender to God?
All right.
Consistently. Not now and then, consistently. That's their way of being. That's what they've chosen. Hearts, our minds can be kept in his peace as we fix our minds and our hearts on him. Psalm 62 puts it like this. He only is my rock. In fact, turn there, Psalm 62. Only 12 verses. The psalm starts off. Making a declaration. And it puts things in perspective. He says, for God alone, I'm reading from the ESV, my soul waits in silence. From him comes my salvation. Now, we could stop right there, because that is the summary, the summation of the other 12 verses. For God alone.
Yes.
Not for God and.
Right.
Fill in the blank.
Wow.
But for God alone. What? My soul. My soul. My attitude, my emotions, my will, that which makes me me, waits alone, and it waits in silence for God. Listen, the silence here doesn't mean no noise.
Come on, break it in.
All right.
The silence here doesn't mean or indicate the absence of noise. That is the way we have interpreted it based on our English culture. For God alone, my soul waits in peace. Check it. In full assurance. My soul waits in confidence. My soul waits in and with full expectation for God alone. Does that mean we don't need others? No, it doesn't. Come on, tell somebody we have to get our theology straight. If we think that we can do life and say we're waiting on God alone at the expense of disregarding people, our theology is screwed. It's screwed and skewed. Simply because the second thing that God requires other than worship of Him alone is regard for one another. How can I regard somebody else and wait for God alone? Check what He says. For God alone, my soul waits. From Him comes my salvation. That doesn't mean deliverance from sin. That's healing, deliverance, victory, everything I need. How many of you have lived long enough to find that many times the Lord works through people to provide what He has for us? Hello! He did not situate us in this life to live solitary lives. But look at what He says. For God alone, I'm waiting for my salvation, for my healing, for my deliverance. In other words, there is and must be a limit, a boundary that is drawn and that is established relative to my expectations of people. Somebody don't get this after a while. Listen, the extent to which you put your confidence and trust in people will be the extent to which you be disappointed. But I thought you said, I said, we are to regard one another, not put our hope and our trust in them. There is a difference. One of the things that happens to us is that we often don't understand who has been assigned to be a blessing or to be a conduit of God's blessing for us. And so we push people away, not understanding that they may be the ones that have been assigned to be that conduit of your blessings. And you can say all day, but God knows what. God ain't thinking about what you like. And who you don't like. As a precursor to establish your blessing. Somebody needs to hear this. Listen here. Sometimes it's the toothless, stinking person that is assigned to bless your socks off. But you can't get the blessing because you're looking at the package. Not discerning, but judging. That's why from God alone, my expectation is of Him alone. My God. I will have discerning as to what that package contains.
Yes, Lord. Yes.
The word puts it like this: beware the way you entertain strangers. that you entertain what? It matters.
My dear.
It matters.
Oh, yes, Lord.
For a lot of my life, man, I didn't think it mattered. I tell you to go take a walk in the out of my face. You got issues? Take you and your issues to the lake and jump in it. Your brother and your sister, and understand that there ain't nothing about me and you outside of them.
Jesus!
Thank you. Let me say it one more time. Yeah. There is nothing between you and God at the expense of everybody else. For you to tear up.
Go ahead, Doc.
The top chapter of the minds is not necessarily a good place here. But I figured if I'm going to spend the night, I'm going to spend it cooking.
Right, okay.
Right.
Something that's going to be practical. I'm just right. a very practical person. The Lord has to help me, and I ask him to help me. Because sometimes practicality is not the thing. Sometimes you need a little more compassion. Amen. Come on, when you call it, praise God, God can help you. Come on, tell somebody. When you identify and tell the truth, God can help you. Amen. When you lying and flossing, praise God, God can help you because you ain't telling the truth. You just a lying heart. That's all. Just say, I want to be stubborn and rebellious. That's it. God. If the people of the Lord would stop being so rebellious, the world could get saved. My God. So I told them, I am your provider. Because God made me the conduit through which you receive your provisions.
Hallelujah.
So get it straight. I did not tell them I was God. That is not what I taught them. I did tell them that they were to expect from God to bless them through me.
Hallelujah.
Somebody didn't get me.
Yes.
I said, when your father sends you something, he is being a conduit of those blessings.
Yes.
Okay.
Nobody else is assigned. Get what I just said?
Assigned.
Parents, young parents, you need to teach your children. Nobody else is assigned to provide for you. But you. It'll cut down the sugar daddies. It'll cut down all you know, people trying to entrap them with things. Because they understand that you are the assigned conduit of blessing. Was I the only one who gave them things and blessed them? Absolutely not.
Jesus.
But it was an understanding in our family, with my siblings, and anybody else who wanted to give them, if they were close to me, run it through me.
Hallelujah.
Sound like control to me, no, sound like wisdom to me. My kids didn't feel beholden to nobody. When they got old enough to go on dates, at that time they had pay phones, y'all. Some of y'all don't know about pay phones because you're too young.
Lord!
They always had money for the phone. Come on, say money. Not a lot, but enough for a phone call. Somebody didn't hear me. No cell phones. In other words, you ain't got to do nothing you don't want to do. Somebody, you see. God says, put your hope and confidence in me, and you won't have to do nothing you don't want to do. Many times we're entrapped and we're ensnared and we are addicted and we're strung out because we've said yes and we've bowed the knee to things and people who have not meant us good and through whom the Lord had not directed and assigned our blessings.
Hallelujah! Yes!
Good word.
He might have been fine. But if he didn't lead you to Jesus,
uh-oh.
say they are fine, I guess. Hot, whatever. Is she too hot? She just too hot. You don't even eat habanero. Some of that stuff that's hot, you need to let it go. It's too hot. It's too hot. If it's not taking you, praise God, to God, if it's not leading you to the cross, if it's not leading you to the altar, if y'all can't pray every day and stay in the Word, praise God, and all be around folks.
Oh, yes, Lord.
Always got to be separated at somewhere close in the dark in the corner in the back. What you sneaking for? If it's all right and it's all light, then why you sneaking in the back, in the corner, in the dark? If it's light, everybody needs to see. If it's light, then you're not ashamed. If it's light, your mama, your daddy, your brothers, your sisters, everybody know they need. Touch with you. What's the secret? Light. Why you hiding it under a bushel? My God, today. He only. Well, how'd she get all of that out of this one? Listen, when God is the only one, then God is the only one. While you're loving everybody else, you're not expecting salvation from them. Wow. Hallelujah. Wow. You're not gravitating toward that barbecue ice cream. I'm gonna give you the moon and he on the bus. Are you kidding me? Who are we fooling? He got a car that keeps stays in the shop. Come on. But he gonna give you the moon. How? Get out of here.
Hallelujah.
Come on, sometimes we just need to wake up. Come on, Tatiana, wake up. You can't believe everything. When people are enamored and they full of whatever they full of, then you know what I'm saying. Anything will come out under pressure.
Right. Yep.
That's why y'all need to stay in the light.
Hallelujah.
Come on, tell somebody, let some light shine on it. You got to stay in the dark, honey, is suspect. Come on, somebody, come on, tell somebody. If you got to keep it hidden. Come on, tell, don't be ashamed. Tell if you've got to keep it hidden. Chances are, it's not your blessing. For God alone, from Him comes my salvation. Hallelujah. Stop jumping and hopping and talking and being so upset.
Hallelujah.
And anxious about finding a spouse. Find Jesus. When the spouse is no longer there. You see, when you have Jesus, Jesus never fails. He'll never leave you or forsake you. So many times we want to gravitate to the temporary. Our God is passion. Our God tends to be elusive. It tends to be what we want to say is romantic. We want to say, well, I'm just human. Well, you and your humanity, God says, surrender to me. Do you not? Come on, tell somebody, God is not. Do you think that the Creator?
Come on.
The one who created you didn't know that you would have, I'm going to say, creative energies.
My God. Oh, that's good. Being nice,
you
get it.
I love it.
Being very nice.
Come on, y'all need to hear me. Do you really think that? Do you think that the one who made you is surprised when you have itches that you can't scratch? Do you think that the one who made you is surprised or taken aback when showers don't help you? Cold showers, runs around the whatevers, when they no longer help. Do you think your creator is taken aback? I didn't say your friends, I said your creator. The one who made you. He made you the way you are. But he tells you what to do with what he made. And how many of you know we don't always act or follow the directions of the manufacturer? And sometimes we don't get things together the way the instructions or the directions indicate or say specifically we should put them together. But we want it to work, but we don't want to follow the instructions. So when it starts acting a certain kind of way, we want to go to God and say, certainly you made a mistake. Are you really saying you want me to come out from among them and be separate? Are you kidding me?
Jesus.
I got to have.
Mercy.
Oh my.
Did you think
mercy.
Your creator
mercy.
Had his eyes covered mercy. Or closed mercy. When he made you?
Talking about him whatever.
Absolutely yeah. Not. Come on, tell somebody he knows everything about me. I need you to tell a couple of people that, because the enemy would have you be blindless and have you think that he's forgotten. God has not forgotten how he made you. But he has put some instructions in the manual. And if you don't read the manual, you won't know how it's supposed to operate. And you won't have the satisfaction of it operating optimally because you haven't allowed or followed the instructions.
Amen.
Help me.
Ah.
Jesus.
Help me, Father.
And so these creative life-giving energies that he's put in each one of us, some to a greater degree than others of us. Guess what? He knows how to direct them. And he will direct them if you give them to him. Many times, our problem is not that he won't direct, but that we won't give them to him because we think this is something we can handle ourselves. And those of you who've been handling it yourself, have you noticed that you don't usually get it right? You may experience an explosion of a second or two, but nothing that is fulfilling and long-lasting, because it is not the assigned blessing for you. The life-giving creative forces and energies that God has made us with, he wants to direct in ways that will give him glory. Come
on, tell somebody, give him glory. Not give you a euphoric experience, but give him glory. You see, it becomes a question of who's God. It becomes a question of who's in charge. And when you begin to tell the truth about that, you can allow him to order your steps. It's not a problem now, but several years ago somebody asked me, well, how come? In fact, my granddaughter just asked me the other day. Hallelujah. Oh, Granny, how come you don't have a boyfriend? I said, for
Jesus,
what?
Jesus, hallelujah! That's enough.
Whoa.
I did.
All right.
Absolutely.
Oh, mercy on me.
Good answer.
For what?
Mercy on me.
Mighty God.
I've grown to the place in God where I don't need anybody to pacify me. My self-esteem is not so bad, Pam, that I have to have somebody to hold my hand.
It's
all good.
Jesus, hallelujah.
I don't have to have nobody to go to the movies with me if I want to go.
Jesus.
Where I want to go. Don't have to ask nobody's opinion.
Jesus.
Somebody ain't hear me. I just need somebody to talk to. I counsel all day long. Why don't you get somebody that you can minister the word to? See, I'm talking about things that will bring God glory. See, years ago, I used to work myself to a frenzy so that when I went home, my mind went on nothing but sleep. Somebody needs to hear this. God showed me that I had made it an idol.
That's right.
Wasn't no need to be talking about I was trusting God. No, I was physically spent. It was not bringing God glory, giving God glory. Yeah, helping people for the wrong purpose, with the wrong motivation. Oh, somebody's not hearing me. Wasn't nothing wrong with my libido. I'm 63, but I ain't ancient or old. I ain't no fossil or relic. All that great, don't get it twisted. It don't mean nothing if I don't want it to mean something. Somebody, y'all need to hear what I'm saying. I'm not just talking to young folks, I'm talking to folks. Because we'll allow the enemy to chump us and start putting our confidence and our expectation in other folks and other things when he wants to be the one that we trust. Period.
Thank you, Jesus.
Help me, Father.
So she said, Granny, what? I said, what I need one for?
Mercy.
I'm not looking to get married. In a soon time. She just started laughing. Why you have to get married? Because the Bible says that is the way I would need to do what you think I should do without being married. I'm talking about following the direction. Come on, tell somebody follow the directions. Come on, tell somebody else, follow the directions. See, the Creator gave directions, and they're directions that you have to follow if you want to get the promises. Not get them, but receive them and see them. The promises have been given to us, but many times we walk askance from them because we can't recognize them because our eyes are jaded, our understanding not enlightened.
Mighty. Hallelujah. Lord Jesus.
You keep thinking it's him or her that's keeping you. I'm going to tell you when they walk out.
Wow.
Or when they no longer are here. Where is your hope? Where is your help? What happens to your heart and your mind? When they go, does your God go? Able to have the feel good. Come on, tell somebody life happens. Say, so I'm gonna tell you, you can be married and life happens. Things happen. And can cut off your little joy stick. So the truth is, can you live?
Yes.
That's what I'm talking about, idolatry. Can you live? Can you exist? Can you have quality living? When that which excites you, enravish you, can you still live? When it's no longer there.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Father.
All right now.
Thank you, Father.
Jesus.
Thank you, Heavenly Father.
That's right.
Thank you, Heavenly Father.
I'm telling you, there's life.
Thank you.
After.
After.
Jesus. Hallelujah.
When passion is only in your mind.
Bless your name.
There's life. Why him alone? Because he's the only one who's promised never to leave you alone. Come on, tell somebody he promised never to leave you. Come on, tell a couple of people that you need to remember he promised never to leave you. He's the only one who had promised that and can keep it. No flesh and blood can keep that promise. Even if they promise it, and we've said things in passion, baby, I'll never leave you, I'll always. You know, you can't keep that. You, tomorrow's not promised to you. The next minute is not promised to you. So if you've been lying to folks telling them that, stop it. Stop it. Baby, you know I ain't going nowhere. Shut up. Find something else to say. Because that is a lie. You don't know. The Bible says we don't know the day or the hour when the Son of Man. You don't know. So don't make promises that you can't keep. It's not within your power to keep them. That next verse says, he only is my rock. And my salvation. Here we go again. My fortress, I shall not be greatly shaken. Because I'm depending on him. You cannot allow folks to take the place of God in your life. You cannot allow things to take the place of God in your life. And it can't be him and them because he says, I'm jealous. You ain't gonna two-time me. I ain't gonna take back seat. I ain't gonna be the second fiddle either. I won't share my glory.
Hallelujah.
It can't be me and.
Jesus. Hallelujah.
Continue with my granddaughter. I said, you know, baby, God has been merciful to me. I've done all that I need to do and more. And if you would listen to me, your life would be a lot easier too.
Yeah.
Because I try to tell you how to do what you think you want to do.
Right.
And not get caught up.
Absolutely.
And the way to do that is to follow the directions.
Absolutely.
Come on, tell somebody, follow the directions. See, there's no need of having medicine, going to the doctor, taking medicine, and you take it the way you want to take it, and don't follow the directions. Come on. Follow the directions. No need to talk my heart. It ain't working. Have you ever taken it according to the directions? Come on, tell somebody God's way is the best way. God is not trying to keep us from having fun, but he wants us to have stability. Come on, tell somebody. He wants us to have stability and peace of mind. Come on, tell somebody. He wants us to have stability and peace of mind. Some of you know what I'm talking about. You've gotten stuff, praise God, too hot to handle. You had to turn it up, turn it loose. Too much.
Mercy.
And something happens with your vision when you get closer up on something. And you can see what it is. Come on now. Y'all can act pious if you want. You know exactly what. That's why you need to stay with folks. Amen. Company. Amen. You just met somebody and met them over the internet and you go and invite them to your space or they invite you to their space. What's that about? What's wrong with you? Come on. Do you know that idolatry can lead you into a mindless fury?
Yes.
Amen. Where you stop thinking and you black out? Come on, have any of you ever blacked out? Do you know what I'm talking about? You stop thinking. Your senses, your intellect just stop moving. You got in a fog. I know it's just the three of us. Praise God. Hallelujah. Can't see straight. Can't see. And the damnable thing is that we won't get help. We can't see, but we won't ask for help. So pride takes us under the arm and propels us, walks us right into the lion's den. You ain't got no protection except God said, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. So you live to see and to see today, praise God, where you can hear this message that it was a god, it was an idol, and you still got it, so let go of it. Help us today.
Help me, Father. Help me,
Daddy.
Hello?
Help me, Father.
You can't let it go, it's an idol. So you need to decide, I'm going to release everything that does not bring God glory. Will it happen automatically? It depends on your volition. Some of us, it'll take a little longer than others of us. But you need to start. Come on, tell somebody, start. And you start by opening your mouth and declaring it. Amen. 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 Jesus is my Lord. He's not just my Savior, but he's my Lord.
Yes.
A lot of folks have him as their Savior, but they live ragged, unproductive lives because he's not their Lord. And I'm going to tell you young folks and you folks who want to be married and all that, when y'all got to get jumped in, you know, in comfort zones and your passions, praise God, before you even really know each other's name, that ain't your blessing. I'm going to say it again. When you got to get busy before you put a ring on it, that ain't your blessing. When you follow the directions and do what God says, then he promises marital bliss. Don't expect it. You're not following the directions. Hallelujah. He only is my rock. He only is my stability. He only is my source of security. Only him.
Jesus.
Janelle was talking about prayer before. Do you know you will not have answered prayer? She already told. If you don't have faith.
Right.
The Bible says, when you come to me, come what? Knowing, believing. That one, I am. And that I am a rewarder of those who follow the directions. Come knowing I can direct your path. Come knowing I can make those life-giving energies flow in a way that will bring me glory. I'm a witness. He can take it to a point, praise God, that will bring him glory. Young person asked me last week, well, what do you do about libido? What do you do about it? You give it to the one who made it. Don't be saying take it. He ain't gonna take it because he made you with it. But he can direct it in a way that will bring him glory. Until such time as is appropriate. Come on, say appropriate. Come on, follow the directions. That is after you say, I do.
Lord, mercy.
Not when you say we might.
Might.
Or someday.
Someday.
My Lord. Father, we thank you for your living word. We thank you that you love us so much. Instructions and your directions, and you give us grace to walk them out. And we thank you. We praise you. Thank you. That you don't forsake us even when we turn our heads to the Lord. And we put up the hand and say, we don't want to hear. Help us. Work in us both to will and to do of your good pleasure. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Help us to be astute and diligent in walking by faith. Faith in you. Dependency on you. In the name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord, that while we're in that walk, that we receive your peace. Your stability, your security. Thank you, we receive your love. Thank you for loving us. Thank you, Jesus. That even as you've loved us, we'll love others. And that, Lord, those who want to be married, that they will be a blessing, not just seeking to be blessed, but that they would be a blessing. To the extent that it is your will, thank you for godly, healthy marriages within this house.
in Jesus. You said marriage was honorable. So we thank you for honorable, wholesome, healthy relationships, marriages, in Jesus' name. Let us not be complacent or comfortable walking askew, walking widely, and not adhering to your directions. Keep us by the power of your life. Help us to surrender all to you. We give you glory, we give you honor, we thank you. In Jesus' name, amen. Those of you who ask somebody next to you, do you know Jesus as your Lord and Savior? The answer is no. Ask them, do they want to be born again? If their answer is yes, walk them up to the front. Praise God. Where they will be taken aside and shown through the word of God how to be born from receiving Jesus Christ as personal Savior. How you can make him Lord of your life. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Ask the person next to you, have you received the Holy Spirit? With the New Testament evidence of speaking in tongues. As the Spirit of the Lord will give you the language. If they're born again and they say no, but they desire to receive the infilling of the Holy Spirit, walk them up. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. All right, ask the people around you, do you have a church home?
Do you have a church home?
If their answer is no, ask them, would you like to become a member of Los Angeles Shabbat? One thing you can guarantee them, thank God, is that they won't come to a three-ring circus. They will get the truth. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. All right, those of you who want to worship the Lord in the giving of your tithes and offerings, let's give the Lord a hand praise. Hallelujah. God's blessing from you. Hallelujah. It's not the lottery. California, Illinois, Nevada. None of them. Praise God. I thank the Lord my mother tied for my daddy. I thank the Lord he gave her his money to do it. If he didn't have sense enough, he was betting on the running numbers, Janelle. Trying to get some love. But the Lord blessed us out of the tithe that my mother was able to give. I praise the Lord. Glory to his name. Come on, tell somebody there's a blessing in giving. In fact, there's a hundredfold blessing assigned to the giver, to the Lord. Then the devourer is rebuked for the sake of the tithe. Hallelujah. Bring the Lord an offering. Bring the Lord your tithes and offerings. If you need assistance, raise your hand. Someone will help you. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Bless the name of the Lord. LASFC.org. That is your church website. And I encourage you to visit it. There are some surprising new things you'll see, and I believe you'll be blessed. LASFC.org. Amen.
Amen.
Tell somebody that's our website.
Just
need to make sure you got it. You bringing some more money, baby? Yes, ma'am. Praise God. Have all given who desire to give? Anybody else desire to give? If all given who desire to give. Okay, Brother Stewart, I see you. Thank you. I don't see your wife. Just tell her I asked about it. Put your hands towards your giving. Father, thank you for the opportunity to worship you in the giving of our tithes and offerings. We thank you, Lord, for more than enough to meet the needs of this ministry, Lord God, and those who have given. We thank you for the hundredfold return in Jesus' name. We thank you, Lord, that the devourer is rebuked for the sake of each tither in Jesus' name. Bless your people and make them a blessing in the name of the Lord Jesus. Those standing in faith for jobs and promotions, Lord God, I thank you. for your grace. I thank you that you open doors and make ways in the name of Jesus. Help their unbelief in Jesus' name. And grant unto them your bountiful blessings. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Help us, Lord, to follow your directions in every area of our lives, in Jesus' name. We give you glory, we give you honor, we give you praise in Jesus' name. Those in agreement say amen.
Amen.
Would you stand?
Thank you.
If you got a Bible from the usher, would you please pass it to the...